secretary. At the commission, we refer to commission secretary, because in the corporate world, it's company secretary, but also legal counsel. So he will talk to us about the amended constitution with emphasis on elections. So shall we please welcome Mr. Kamwi.
Thank you very much. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
I'm sure if you like loud enough, because the small the room is a bit smaller. So that everyone in at the back can hear what I'm saying. So my presentation will be on the election provisions in the amended constitution. There are a lot of comments. Some people are very particular with words. When you say amended constitution, others say the new constitution. So there are some who even question that and say, no, this is not a new constitution. You should call it amended constitution. But I want to believe that is only semantic, because even if it is an amended constitution, it still has new provisions. So those provisions are new. And can safely say more than 25% of the constitution of Zambia was adopted in 1991, amended in 1996, has actually radically changed. So it qualifies to be a new constitution, just that the Bill of Rights were not touched, and also Article 79 on the powers of Parliament. So except for these two, the Bill of Rights and Article 79, the constitution is wholly new because everything else has changed. But for official purposes, it's called an amended constitution. So here, I will talk about the election provisions in the same amended constitution. Suffice to mention from the beginning that we have seen a lot of new provisions in terms of elections, particularly for the elections to the office of president, the elections to the office of member of parliament. There's also a new feature under local government elections, because in the past, we used to vote for councillors only in the wards, but under the constitution, a new dimension has been introduced, whereby citizens will now be voting for their mayors also, mayors and for council chairman, or council chairperson rather. So what it means is that local government elections have been expanded along those lines to provide for the election of the mayor. We take for Lusaka as an example. At the same time, we are voting for our area members of parliament in the constituencies. At the same time, we'll be voting for a mayor of the whole city of Lusaka directly. In the past, the councillors were the ones who used to elect and vote for a mayor during a council meeting. But now the voters will be doing that. So what it means is that the mayor will be an executive position. It will be a very powerful position, actually. And the mayor will serve for 5 years, because the mandate will be for 5 years. And then the mayor will have a greater area of responsibility. An MP looks after a constituency, but the mayor will look after a city. So for a chairperson, when we go to our neighbor in Zilanga here, or Shimunji, which are not cities, they are not even municipal councils, those will put into place council chairpersons, not a mayor, but along the same lines. So the new provisions, particularly for presidential elections, we have the famous majoritarian system, which is called the famous 50% plus one. This clause has been the cry of stakeholders for many constitutional review commissions, starting from 1991, the Mbunga Constitution, the Manakato Constitution in 1996, another Mbunga Commission again, the Mungomba Constitution, and then also the National Constitution Conference, who were all asking that we need to have a